Okay, when I'm ready.
Ready?
Okay, I'm going to go over the procedure for starting this 900 series coherent argon laser. First thing we do is we switch on the power supply. This is a 220 volt three phase electrical supply. And second step is turn on the water. It's a water cooled laser tube. Third step is to turn the on off switch and flip up the ready. But now you're going to see the laser power will gradually warm up to tell us how much power is on here. Take a little while. There we go. Okay, now let's dial it up to the maximum power, not that we use it. 1.1 watts is very good. Now, usually it's used between 200 and 300, basically. Now, you know there's a all green and a blue-green and a green method of using this. For most procedures, the blue-green designation works. If you're doing delicate work around a macula, switch it to the green, and that reduces the amount of damage to the retinal layers. So, but I'm going to keep it for this purpose of this test. We're going to keep it on the blue green. Now, okay. Now we'll go to the console. You have to switch a few buttons on. Switch that up. And that, and here is the this knob here controls the on off for the light. So you can see the varies the intensity of the light by turning this. And there is the aiming beam, which is the intensity of that is regulated with this. I usually keep it not all the way up high, but like one notch below the high. Okay, so of course there's a foot pedal here. I'm briefly going to do a few zaps on a box to show it's working nicely. Oh, one other thing. If you want to move the aiming beam, we have a switch over here. You press this down, and then you can move the aiming beam with this little rod here. See how that moves? You want to have it right on the white light. So we press down on this to lock it in place. Okay. Now we're going to do a little laser on this cardboard box. Won't hurt anything. Nice burns in this thing. Okay, she's working. That basically explains the major controls. If you ever have to change a light bulb, you have to go in here. There's a screw there. You remove the bulb. Make sure that the bulb is all the way in. I don't want to open it up. Make sure the bulb is all the way in, or else you're not going to get a good white beam. Okay, we'll let that run a little bit to warm up the tube. Now let's bring our attention to the coherent 2500 YAG machine. This uses a standard 110 volt supply. Turn it on, we have a key. Again, put the key in here. Okay. Now I want your attention to this, the readout on these LED displays. Now this is a little tricky. We have to wait till all these 888 numbers disappear in it. Then it'll be ready to prime. be patient. Now these two buttons, one turns on this little lamp, the other one power, so we flip those two buttons up. This is the up down on the console. Okay, now we're ready to begin the test firing procedure. Keep pressing this. Now that signifies that it's ready. The green ready button lights up. It's ready. Okay? Now this shows the energy. Usually for when I'm doing air capsulotomies, I like it the power to be approximately 4 millijoules. So that's what we have it. It's activated with this push button on the joystick. So let's just do a little bit of YAG lasering on this cardboard box. Again, we have to bring the... This is tricky. I guess an ophthalmologist would know how to do this, but there is a technique to getting this done. You want to put the YAG beam on the capsule, not on the lens, because you can get pitting if you do it on the lens. Basically, there we go. Let me see. Oh, that's working great. You're going to see two red lights. You got to get the light into a single beam. So this is working very nicely. We'll let this warm up a little bit more, but that basically explains how to use these two machines. And of course, it's important to zero in the eyepieces for your own... set it at zero if you're using eyeglasses, or else dial in your eyeglass prescription in these. It's very critical that you focus the beam slightly behind the capsule so you don't pit the intraocular lens. And you can also use this for iridectomies, peripheral iridectomies, that's another matter. Or I actually like to use the coherent argon laser for peripheral iridectomies.